capitalize on the keywords and the key phrases which are from the newspaper. So I emphasize the keywords and the key phrases which are from the newspaper, and by emphasizing, that is by trying to get into the mode of highlighting the keywords and the key phrases from the newspaper, we will identify the factual, analytical and also the conceptual questions which will be very, very useful for the prelims examination point of view. So definitely you will be beneficial for prelims point of view in regards to the factual, analytical and conceptual questions. And I will also make you understand the importance of imbibing or inculcating the keywords and the key phrases in answer writing. In answer writing, that is in regards to the mains examination, wherein your answer for the mains examination has to be precise and concise. That means it has to be to the point what is being asked by the UPSC or the State Public Service Commissions in the mains examinations. And you will definitely, your answers would be precise and concise when you imbibe the keywords and the key phrases in your answer writing, that means the mains examination. Thereby, you will score higher marks in the mains examination. So, this session or my session will help you for both prelims and mains for 2020 as well as 2021. And today's session is in regards to the daily news analysis from the Hindu, that is today, 18th July 2020. And before I get into the topic, I would say a very good morning to everyone who is in the live and also in the live chat. Very good morning to you all. Good morning Rahul, Nandita, Praveen Kumar, Anil Kumar, H-A-N-E-E-L, Anil, Malvika Sajivan, all of you very good morning. Shiva Murthy has also joined, very good morning Shiva. RS Studio, very good morning to you. And then the quote for the day is, work hard in silence, work hard in silence, let success make the noise. So for today's quote of the day is, work hard in silence, let success make the noise. So what is important is, along your or throughout your preparation, let there be silence, no noise at all, let there be silence and no noise, and let there be noise, and let there be noise only when you have the success, and only your success should make noise, only your success should make noise. So definitely this is, I liked it very much for the quote of the day, work hard in silence, let success make the noise. Lokesh Chandra also has joined, very good morning. Balu Anji, Sravani, very good morning to you all. And quote of the day, once again I repeat, it is, work hard in silence, let success make the noise. And today's newspaper, we'll get into the topic, that is today's newspaper, which talks about reformed multilateralism. This is very, very important keyword, reformed multilateralism. And please do write it in your book. Keyword, this is the keyword, reformed multilateralism. Shravani has also joined, very good morning to you. So what is reformed multilateralism and why this reformed multilateralism has been taken up or has been used by our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, where at the United Nations meet. So it was a video conferencing meet which has been taken up, and then our Prime Minister Narendra Modi is emphasizing on the reformed multilateralism. I've said it, but it's a couple of days back also, our Prime Minister or India is pushing for the reforms in the United Nations Security Council. I did say this, that India is pushing for reforms in the United Nations Security Council, and our Prime Minister Narendra Modi has spoken at the word or using the reformed multilateralism or reforms in the multilateralism, and he has spoken at where? At ECOSOC. What is this ECOSOC? Is also again very important for prelims point of view from international relations. ECOSOC. So what is ECOSOC? It is an organ. It is a branch of United Nations. It is a branch of United Nations Organization, UNO. It is a branch of United Nations Organization, one of the branch. Please do understand, it is one of the branch of United Nations Organization. It is called as Economic and Social Council. Economic and Social Council. So the meeting, high level dialogue or the high level meeting, it has taken place at United Nations Organization, one of the organ, that is ECOSOC, and there our Prime Minister Narendra Modi has spoken about multilateralism, and the subject there and the subject at the ECOSOC, it is called as ECOSOC, that is Economic and Social Council. Economic and Social Council, this is again very important keyword, because it is one of the organ of United Nations organizations. So there they have the subject there was multilateralism after COVID-19. Please do understand, multilateralism, India has spoken about reformed multilateralism, but the subject was multilateralism after COVID-19. Multilateralism after COVID-19. And there, Prime Minister Narendra Modi is emphasizing on the 75th anniversary of United Nations. So this year, 2020, next year, 2020 and 2021, 2020-2021, next year, it will be, that is why even India has pushed very hard for the non-permanent member. India will be the non-permanent member of United Nations Security Council. I will explain about non-permanent member and permanent members also, fine. So India wanted that reformed multilateralism with a reformed United Nations. So definitely, as I said, that India is definitely pushing for reforms in the United Nations, and especially in the United Nations Security Council. And this has been raised once again by the government of India in the high level meeting or the dialogue at the ECOSOC, Economic and Social Council. And the subject is what? This is very important. What was the subject at ECOSOC? The subject was multilateralism after COVID-19. So after COVID-19, what is that the entire globe or United Nations is looking at? So definitely there we have seen the United Nations General Secretary, United Nations Secretary General, that is Antonio Guterres, along with our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and then Norwegian Prime Minister Erna Solberg, and then Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi was also present at the ECOSOC gathering, which was virtually. So what is important is here, United Nations ECOSOC, that is Economic and Social Council, high level gathering has taken place, and there the subject was multilateralism after COVID-19, wherein what kind of reforms will be taken up in the United Nations at the 75th anniversary, And it was along with the United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres, Norwegian Prime Minister Erna Solberg, and along with that the Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi. Where did we come across this person, Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi? Wang Yi, and I said Ajit Doval. Where did we come across this? This was in regards to the special representative level talks. I did say this. Special representative level talks between India and China has taken place between Ajit Doval, who is the National Security Advisor Prime Minister, that is for India, National Security Advisor, and Wang Yi is the Foreign Minister. So Wang Yi, we have also looked at him, the news has come, we have looked at the news. That is Wang Yi and Ajit Doval both have had discussions, that is on the basis of the special representative level talks, to ease the tension between India and China along the LAC. Why I'm saying is, I'm trying to recap once again. Foreign Minister Wang Yi and Ajit Doval, the discussion was in regards to the special representative level talks between India and China. That is how you need to keep on linking. Why I'm saying is, not just reading and then forgetting. No, you have to link it with what you said, today's paper with yesterday, or a week ago, or a fortnight ago, or a month ago. That is what is important. Linking and analysis. Linking and analysis. Read, understand, read, understand, link and analyze the newspaper. Then you will be very, very comfortable for the prelims, mains and for the interview also. So please do get into this mode, read the newspaper, understand the newspaper, linking the newspaper and analyze the newspaper. So this is what we are doing and my sessions will be definitely making you get into that mode of action. And this is an additional information I am giving you here, which is not from, which is not in the newspaper. But when we are talking about the ECOSOC, you need to understand about, or you need to know the information about United Nations. I said United Nations has six principal organs and one of it is, I said, ECOSOC, that is Economic and Social Council. So we will look at what are the six, what are the six principal organs. So one is the United Nations General Assembly, UNGA, and the other one is United Nations Security Council. Third one is ECOSOC, that is Economic and Social Council. Fourth one is Trusteeship Council. Fifth is International Court of Justice, ICJ. Sixth is the United Nations Secretariat. So these are very, very important for prelims point of view. And as well as mains also for international relations. For international relations. If any of the student here in our class is opting for the optional subject, that is political science and international relations. If anyone is opting for political science and international relations, it is very important that you need to understand each and every organ of the United Nations thoroughly, detailed I am saying. So for prelims point of view, this is enough. That is, what are the six principal organs of United Nations? United Nations General Assembly, United Nations Security Council, Economic and Social Council, Trusteeship Council, International Court of Justice and United Nations Secretariat. And I said that United Nations Secretariat, UN Secretary General is who? Antonio Guterres. This is again very important. Antonio Guterres is very important. And before I get into the topic, yeah, Ravelli has joined, Sheikh Wasim has joined, Madhu, Ram, everyone, very good morning to you all. Very good morning to you all. And this is very important, the United Nations for the prelims point of view. So this is an additional information for your betterment. I mean, for you to have a better knowledge about the ECOSOC. Not just, you should not just, what you should think, oh, what is this ECOSOC? No, you need to know what are the other principal organs. So ECOSOC is one of the principal organ. Okay, Rahul says PSIR. Okay, Rahul, I think even Madhu is also into that, if I'm not wrong. And I do not know about others, but yes, you need to get into this mode of understanding. Okay, fine. So, what our Prime Minister has said is multilateral systems more representative. And he is focused on seeing. So, this is a keyword. Please do understand this keyword and please write it in your answer book. That is, he is referring that India believes. Is referring, or Prime Minister has referred, that India believes in the path to achieve sustainable peace and prosperity. Sustainable peace and prosperity. So this is very, very important. So India is wanting to get into the mode of United Nations Security Council. There should be a reforms, multilateralism, reforms, and India is in the path of sustainable. India is in the path of sustainable peace and prosperity. Keyword, please do understand. These are the keywords which are very, very important, and you will definitely score more marks when you are imbibing or inculcating or using these keywords in your mains answers. Mains answers. So, India is in the path to achieve sustainable peace and prosperity. Through what? Through multilateralism. And definitely what our Prime Minister has also made a statement at the virtual summit is that India has fought against the COVID-19. It has helped more than 150 countries. It has extended the assistance. Definitely we have seen the hydroxychloroquine has also been supplied to Southeast Asian countries, South Asia, and also in regards to Israel or West Asia. And also in regards to the US and Europe, India has supplied, and also Africa, So India has supplied the hydroxychloroquine. This is anti-malarian drug, hydroxychloroquine. This is not in the news, but I am saying you how India has assisted, extended his assistance to 150 countries to fight against the COVID-19 pandemic situation. Not only that, India has also gone ahead with setting up of SARS COVID-19 emergency fund. This is very important. SARC COVID-19 emergency fund. Not only that, India has also helped, as I said, South Asian countries. Yes, it did extend its assistance to our neighboring countries, South Asian countries. So this is again very important for prelims point of view. That is hydroxychloroquine, because India is the manufacturing hub or the pharmaceutical hub of the world. India is pharmaceutical hub of the world. Please do understand all this. Whatever I am writing is very, very important. India is pharmaceutical hub of the world. China is manufacturing hub of the world. And here if you look at, yes, once again I'll just refresh it. United Nations General Assembly, United Nations Security Council, United Nations Economic and Social Council, this is ECOSOC. And then United Nations Trusteeship Council, fourth one, International Court of Justice, sixth one is the Secretariat. So these are all the one, that is the six principal bodies of the UNO. And then Ravinder Nayak has joined. Very good morning. Good morning to you, Ravinder Nayak. And here our Prime Minister Modi has also emphasized that the government has extended that 20 lakh crores of rupees during the COVID-19 pandemic situation. So that was the economic stimulus package. Why? To bring back the economy back on track, to build the infrastructure and to place the technological driven. So what is important is here to bring back the economy back and to develop or to build the infrastructure what is required to bounce back, what is required for the business revival, and to place the technological driven system. So definitely we need to go ahead with bouncing back, we need to revive our economy by taking in place or by making sure that technology system is used effectively, and this is again very important for you in regards to the United Nations Security Council, because in the United Nations Security Council we have the permanent member and then non-permanent members. And permanent members are 5 countries, non-permanent is 10 countries. Totally in the United Nations Security Council you have 15 members. In that, permanent members, non-permanent members. Permanent members are 5, non-permanent members are 15. So these are the 5. So what are the 5? China, France, Russia, UK and USA. So what are the permanent members? This is very, very important for prelims point of view. So United Nations Security Council has 15 members, total members are 15, 5 are permanent members and then non-permanent members are 10. So out of 5 permanent members, which are the countries which are the permanent members are China, France, Russia, UK and USA. And in regards to the non-permanent members, which are 10, or again this you have representation. You call this as representation. What is representation is, like you have African continent wherein 3 countries can have the non-permanent members for every 2 years. Only 3 countries from the African continent. Please do understand this. Only 3 countries from the African continent and 2 countries from Asia, 2 countries from Latin America, 2 countries from Western Europe and others. And from Eastern Europe, you have Western Europe and Eastern Europe. Eastern Europe, 1. So totally 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So look at this. This is very important for conceptual point of view. For conceptual point of understanding of the civil services subjects or the topics, that is in regards to the United Nations Security Council. So this is very, very important. Africa, the representation from the African continent is 3 countries. From Asia 2, from Latin America 2, and then Western Europe and others 2, and Eastern Europe 2. So here Asia, India was now. For 2021, India will be the non-permanent member of the United Nations Security Council. But India is pushing very hard. India is pushing very hard for the permanent seat. Please do understand here. India is pushing very hard for the permanent seat that is in the United Nations Security Council. India is pushing very hard to be the permanent member of UNSC. But which is a country which is not really happy with India's constant push to be the permanent member of UNSC? That is, China is not really happy. So this, please do understand, this is very, very important for prelims and conceptual understanding. And you have another news which talks about the reforms in penal laws. This is very important. So the keyword here is reforms in penal laws or criminal laws. Penal or criminal laws. So this is again very important for. So what is the keyword here? Keyword is that reforms in penal criminal law. So the government of India, it has set up a national committee to reform or to go ahead with reforms in the penal laws. The government of India has gone ahead with setting up of national committee. Please do understand, these are all very, very important for prelims and your understanding of what is happening exactly. What is happening exactly in the Indian criminal law? So, the government of India under the Home Ministry, Ministry of Home or Home Ministry, under the Ministry of Home Affairs, under the Ministry of Home Affairs, it has set up a national committee to reform the penal laws. And it is saying that the Indian criminal laws have to be overhauled. Overhauled in the sense repaired or rebuilt or reformed. You can use these words. That is, repair it, rebuild it or reform. In what? 6 months. So, that is what the government of India under Ministry of Home Affairs, it has set up a national committee to go ahead with reforms in penal or Indian criminal laws. This is very, very important. And who is the chairperson of this national committee? The chairperson is the National Law University Delhi of Delhi Vice Chancellor. The National Law University, that is Delhi University Vice Chancellor, who is Ranbir Singh. And these are all very, very important for prelims point of view. So the government of India has set up a national committee that is for reforms in the penal or criminal laws under the Ministry of Home Affairs, and the chairperson of this national committee to reform the penal laws is the National Law Delhi University Vice Chancellor, that is Ranbir Singh. And the government wants the changes to take place, the repair or changes or rebuild in 6 months. And that is what is concerned now. That means the eminent personalities, that is all the eminent personalities, what is 123 eminent personalities who are former Supreme Court judges, senior lawyers and academicians. So, the Supreme Court judges, former, I am saying former, that is earlier, not now. Supreme Court judges, senior lawyers and academicians. Have written a letter to the National Committee. So, we have looked at the Government of India under Home Ministry has come up with setting up a National Committee for reforms in the Indian penal or criminal laws under the chairperson, that is Ranbir Singh. That is okay. But why it is in news? It is in news because 123 eminent personalities ranging from former Supreme Court judges, senior lawyers and academicians have wrote a letter to the committee. Why they have written a letter to the committee? They say that the 6 months is not sufficient to go ahead with having the reforms or to go ahead with making sure that the suggestions taken up by various walks of the lives will not be sufficient. So they are mentioning that the 6 months, what the Ministry of Home Affairs have given the time for 6 months, is not sufficient at the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic situation. And before I get into the next topic, the same topic, that is next, I would say very good morning to even Azmat Khan also. Very good morning to you, Azmat Khan. And what the eminent personalities or 123 eminent personalities say is that we are actually following this 900 years common law. Please do understand, common law. Fine. And in regards to 900 years, and then 150 years, almost 150 years, we have been following the established jurisprudence. Jurisprudence in the sense legal system. Jurisprudence in the sense legal system. So we have a legal system since almost 150 years, and we have a common law since 900 years. India has been following a common law since 900 years, and we are following, or we have an established jurisprudence, that is a legal system, since 150 years. And we, when we have this common law and then established jurisprudence, how can we just wrap up or go ahead with repairing or reforms or changes within 6 months? And this, what they say is, this time bound for 6 months is a very big questionable, is a very big questionable one. And they are also worried about the Ministry of Home Affairs, which has set up a 5-member committee. As I said, the committee is chaired by the Ranbir Singh. Committee is chaired by Ranbir Singh, and it is, the committee is 5-member committee. It is 5-member committee. All these are very, very important for prelims point of view. It is a 5-member committee, and the 5-member committee is chaired by Ranbir Singh, who is the Vice Chancellor of the Delhi University, National Law Delhi University. So the concern is about this, I said. And what they are raising the concern, that is the 123 eminent personalities, is in that 5-member committee. In the 5-member committee, they say that there is no Dalit representation, there is no Muslim representation, there is no women, there is no transgender, and there are no trade unions in the 5-member panel. That is what the 123 eminent personalities are saying. One is the time bound, 6 months is not sufficient, and there are no Dalits, there are no Muslims, there are no women, there are no transgenders, and there are no trade unions in the 5-member committee set up by the Ministry of Home Affairs. Law and legal system. Okay, Lokesh Chandra says that law and legal system, I have the subject in my last semester as I'm a student. Okay, very good. So it will be very useful for you to get into the more understanding about this, Lokesh, I feel. Pratap says, do you have any online platform other than app or Gplay? Okay, Pratap, very good morning to you. What you can do is, you can visit the AKS IAS website. There you will definitely have the information. Please do visit, and you can also download the mobile app of AKS IAS Academy. And Ramesh has also joined. Very good morning to you, Ramesh. I think, Pratap, I have given you the best of the best information in regards to your, you are asking about, do you have any online platform other than app or Gplay? So this is very important for prelims point of view. And you have another news which talks about the United Nations blacklist Pakistan Taliban leader. So what is the keyword here is, again, please do understand, it is United Nations Security Council's resolution. United Nations Security Council resolution 1267. This is the keyword in this entire news. This is a keyword for the entire news. So, the Tehreek-e Taliban Pakistan, TTP, is the terrorist group or terrorist group. And United Nations has put forth the leader, that is the Tehreek-e Taliban Pakistan's leader, that is Noor Wali Mehsood, has been put under or has been designated as a global terrorist. So Noor Wali Mehsood has been designated as a global terrorist by the United Nations Security Council. By what? United Nations Security Council resolution 1267. This is very, very important. This is very, very important for the prelims point of view. Under which among the following resolution the United Nations Security Council has designated the Noor Wali Mehsood of the Tehreek-e Taliban Pakistan as the global terrorist? So which among the following? 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have the United Nations Security Council resolution 1267, you will have 1275 or 1250 or 1230, whatever. So what is important is 1267. So United Nations Security Council Resolution 1267 has designated Noor Wali Masood of Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan as the global terrorist. Why? Because he has been supporting, he has been on behalf of, and he has supported Al-Qaeda. He has been on behalf or associated and then supporting Al-Qaeda in regards to what? Financing, planning and perpetrating. Perpetrating in the sense like kind of taking action against the any governments across the world. So financing has been done and then planning has been done and perpetrated. That means trying to help them in regards to creating destruction. So they have understood all this financing, planning and perpetrating has been taken up on behalf of what you say TTP by Noor Wali Masood in support of entities associated with Al-Qaeda. So Al-Qaeda was changed to what? ISIS. Later on they have shifted the name to ISIS. What is ISIS? Islamic State in Iraq and Syria. Islamic State in Iraq and Syria. So this, because Al-Qaeda was again designated as a global terrorist organization, not terrorist. Al-Qaeda was designated by UN as a global terrorist organization. So then what Al-Qaeda has done is they have just changed the name, but the organization is same. They have changed the name to ISIS. ISIS is called Islamic State in Iraq and Syria. And this, in the year 2014, they have taken up much of the area, geographical area of Iran and Syria. But now almost Iraq and Syria, the ISIS have been flushed out by the US plus almost 60 countries. Almost US plus 60 countries have together come together and then they have fought against ISIS from 2014, and almost last year 2019 or so they have flushed out all the ISIS terrorist organization from Iraq and Syria. But there is one that is called as Idlib, IDLIB, Idlib province in Syria, which is still under the control of ISIS. Idlib province of Syria, which is still under the control of ISIS. Almost Syrian government is trying to flush out even that. Fine. So these are all additional information I am giving. Islamic State 2014 and US plus 60 forces have flushed out. All that is additional information. So definitely what United Nations Security Council 1267 has said is that they are going to freeze all the assets and travel ban and arms embargo. Embargo in the sense ban. So all because of the United Nations Security Council Resolution 1267, the sanctions have been imposed on the Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan terror group, that is Noor Wali Masood, along with earlier also ISIL, that is ISIS Iraq and Syria in Levant. It is called as Levant, L-E-L, Iraq and Syria in Levant, L-E-V-A-N-T. It is also called as Iraq and Syria in Islamic State in Iraq and Syria, and Al-Qaeda. Both these terrorist organizations were already used by the United Nations Security Council, the Resolution 1267. And now to the Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan terror leader Noor Wali Masood as a global terrorist. And now any assets, all the assets of this person, terrorist, will be freezed, no travel ban, and arms will be totally banned. So this is very important again for what? In regards to the internal security. Internal security. Please do understand. This news is very, very important for internal security. And then Ravinder says, sir, could I get the soft copy of this class? Okay, please do visit, Ravinder, please do visit the www.iasaks.is. And if you look at this Noor Wali Mehsood. He has become the leader of TTP after the death of Maulana Fazlullah. So after Maulana Fazlullah death, Mehsood, Noor Wali Mehsood has been the leader of the TTP. That was in the year 2018, two years back. And TTP is blacklisted since 2011 itself. 2011 itself, it is a blacklisted terrorist organization, 2011 itself, right? And then this Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan terrorist group has also gone ahead with attacking the Pakistan security forces in North Waziristan in July 2019, and they have gone ahead with bomb attack against the Pakistani soldiers in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa in August 2019. So what is important is that the TTP is also responsible for the terrorist attacks in Pakistan against the Pakistani security forces in 2019 in North Waziristan, and also the Pakistani soldiers in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa in August 2019. So July and August 2019, the TTP has been held responsible. They have claimed responsible that they were involved in the attacks against the Pakistani security forces and the soldiers. So about Mehsood, we have looked at this, how they are involved in attacking the security forces of Pakistani soldiers itself. And there is another news in regards to the Supreme Court refuses to entertain plea for uniform and common curriculum. So what is the keyword here is uniform and common curriculum. This is a keyword for school students. For school students. So we will look at what is that. What is that? We would be discussing about the uniform and common curriculum. So uniform and common curriculum for school students. For school students. So if you look at here, the Supreme Court has refused to entertain. Please do understand. So a person has filed a petition in the Supreme Court. In the Supreme Court, a petitioner called as Ashwini Upadhyay has filed a petition in the Supreme Court. Why? To set up a National Educational Council or Commission. And this is again very, very important keyword. So the petitioner, that is the advocate Ashwini Upadhyay, has filed a petition in the Supreme Court so that the government of India or the HRD ministry has to set up a National Education Council or a commission. Why? To follow what? One nation, one board system. These are all very, very important keywords. Please do understand. These are all very, very important keywords for the prelims and mains examination. So the petitioner has filed a petition in the Supreme Court to set up a National Education Council or a commission and to follow one nation, one board system. One nation, one board system. In which he wanted that ICSE, we now have ICSE syllabus and we have CBSE syllabus. So he wanted the merger of ICSE and CBSE syllabus together. And then he wants that both have them to be merged and then come up with one system called as one nation, one board system. And then he wanted the setting up of National Educational Council or commission. And that is called as uniform and common curriculum. So that he wanted a uniform and common curriculum, not a separate curriculum for ICSE syllabus, CBSE syllabus and state syllabus. And state syllabus. He says all that has to be removed. There should be only one curriculum, uniform and common curriculum, and that should be under one nation, one board system, and there has to be a setup of National Educational Council or Commission. So this was the petition which was filed by the advocate Ashwini Upadhyay in Supreme Court. And what is the response of the Supreme Court? The response of the Supreme Court is, the Supreme Court said that it has refused to entertain. That is, it is not accepting The petition of the petitioner, that is Ashwini Upadhyay, it is not accepting. It has refused. It has refused to entertain. Why? Because it says that it is a matter of policy. What it says is in regards to the uniform and common curriculum for school students who are at the age of 6 and 14. At the age of 6 and 14 to have a uniform and common curriculum, what the Supreme Court has said is, we will not entertain this petition. Why? Because, why? Why it said it will not entertain? Because it is a matter of policy. It is a policy matter of the state education and the, what do you say, central education or the HRD. State education or the HRD minister. It is a policy matter. And it says the judiciary cannot command the government. Please do understand, it is a very, very important statement given by the Supreme Court in regards to the education. That is the uniform and common curriculum. It says that it is a policy matter of the state, CBSE, ICSE, and we, that is the judiciary, cannot command the government. Look at it, saying these reasons. Reasons is, it is a policy of matters and we cannot, that is the judiciary cannot command the government, and thereby it has refused to entertain the petitioner for setting up a national education council, and then to follow a one nation, one board, and to follow a one uniform and common curriculum across the country for the students aged between 6 and 14. This is important, between 6 and 14. So this is very, very important for the prelims point of view. And not only that, the petitioner has said that there has to be a standard textbook. He said there has to be a standard textbook. The petitioner said there has to be a standard textbook with chapters on fundamental rights, fundamental duties, and then directive principles, and about the preamble. Please do understand, this is very, very important again for prelims polity point of view. Polity point of view. So what the petitioner, that is Upadhyay, has urged, that there has to be a separate textbook, a new textbook which has to be designed, wherein it will have chapters on fundamental rights, fundamental duties, directive principles, and about the preamble, which has to be a compulsory, and he says it has to be throughout the territory of India for the age 6 to 14. But the Supreme Court has said that no, nothing doing, we cannot. Why? Because as of now itself, the school children are burdened by their books and heavy bags. So now we cannot go ahead with coming ahead with new textbook with this one. Why? Because they are already, that is the school children between 6 and 14 across the country, are burdened by the books, whatever they are having now for their syllabus. And as of now, the bags are heavy, and we cannot go ahead with, what do you say, directing the government, HRD or the state governments, to follow the another textbook. And the petitioner said, uniform, please do understand, I'm reading this entirely for you. Please do understand very carefully. The petitioner, that is Upadhyay, that is the advocate, said that uniform education system having a common syllabus and common curriculum. Why? Why did he come up with this? He's giving the reason. The petitioner is giving the reason why he has filed a petition in the Supreme Court for uniform education system. Because having a common syllabus and common curriculum would achieve the code of common culture, removal of disparity, and depletion of discriminative values in human relation. I repeat once again, he has said that it will achieve the code of common culture. So he is focusing on the Indian culture, common culture, removal of disparity, that is any kind of differences, and then depletion of discriminatory values. Definitely India has that nook and corner of India, we see the discriminatory system which is prevailing in India. So what he says is, because of the common syllabus and the common curriculum, depletion. Depletion in the sense removing. Removing of, removing of discriminatory values in human relation. Look at it, how he has brought in the culture, the disparity, the values he has brought in the petition. And he also said that the common syllabus and the common curriculum would enhance the virtues, improve the quality of life, elevate the thought, elevate in the sense like upgrade or improve or increase, upgrade, improve or increase the thoughts, and which advances, it will advance the constitutional philosophy of equal society. Look at it, he is also saying that there will be equal society. So he has brought in, look at it, I'll use the keywords here, what he has brought in. He has brought in culture, he has brought in values, he has brought in virtues, he has brought in quality of life, he has brought in thoughts, he has brought in social equity or equal social equity. So look at it, these are the keywords. As a civil servant aspirant, you need to focus on this. It is not that a petitioner is filed and then we will just keep quiet. No. Why I am saying these are important is, these are again important because it will be very, very useful in regards to making sure that you will be having more of information in the social issues. You can write this in the mains, in general studies paper 2 of the mains examination in regards to the social issues or Indian society. Social issues or Indian society. You can mention these, what you say, keywords. How we can achieve, whether we can achieve common with, what you say, common syllabus and common curriculum. Please do write it. When I'm saying all these keywords, please do take a note of it. Social equity or equal society. Culture is talking about values, virtues, quality of life and the thoughts also. And then he has mentioned about advanced constitutional philosophy. Look at it, the way he has brought in. Okay, we are not really worried about why Supreme Court has rejected it. But the petitioner has put in those keywords. We need to look at which will be very, very useful for you for the prelims point of view. And there is another news which talks about COVID-19 vaccine and Bharat Biotech starts human trial at RGI Rohtak. So what is important here is the keyword here is human trials. And this is very, very important. That is why I always say that whenever you are looking at the news in the newspaper, you need to focus first the keyword. First the keyword. So what is the keyword here? Human trials. No doubt it is about the vaccine. So the ICMR, Indian Council for Medical Research, Indian Council of Medical Research have said that India will be ready with the vaccine by August 15, 2020. India will be ready with the vaccine. And then it said that Bharat Biotech has been given permission by the ICMR and also the Director Control General of India. Very important. Director Control General of India have been given permission to the Bharat Biotech to go ahead with vaccine, go ahead with coming up with the vaccine for the COVID-19. Fine. And then they have said that the government also, I mean the ICMR has said that it will be ready by August 15. So we are not really worried about whether it will be ready by August 15, but we are worried about the vaccine for the examination point of view, that is called as Covaxin, coronavirus or corona vaccine. It is called as corona vaccine. So it is Covaxin by the Bharat Biotech. These are all very important. And the company involved is Bharat Biotech and the vaccine is Covaxin. Covaxin, as I have written here, the vaccine is Covaxin. Fine. And what it is that the human trials have started. Where it has started? It has started in The PGI, that is the Post Graduate Institute in Rohtak, or PGI Medical Sciences. It has started in, the human trials have started in PG or Postgraduate Institute of Medical Sciences. Postgraduate Institute of Medical Sciences, where? Rohtak. Rohtak is where? Haryana. Please do understand, these are all, what do you say, first time first time India is going ahead with human trials for the vaccine, for the COVID-19 disease. So thereby, there could be possibility that the question could be asked in the prelims, and in one of the statement they would say that Rohtak is, that instead of saying Rohtak, they could say Pune, or they could say even that, what do you say, CCMB, that is Hyderabad. So do not get confused. So the Covaxin has been administered to three of them. Voluntarily they have come forward, humans or individual. Volunteers is the individuals or humans who have come forward voluntarily, that is three of them, and they have administered in the sense they have injected the Covaxin to the three volunteers, which is been by the Bharat Biotech at the Postgraduate Institute of Medical Sciences in Rohtak, Haryana on July 17, that is yesterday, as part of the first phase of clinical trials on humans. This is the key word. First phase of clinical trials on humans. Why I am saying is, there could be a question which could be asked on the clinical trials on the humans for the COVID-19 or COVID-19 disease. Is at the PGI, that is Postgraduate Institute of Medical Sciences, Rohtak, the first phase on three volunteers, which is the virus is been, the corona vaccine for the virus is developed by Bharat Biotech, and it is the clinical trial on humans. And then the doctor there has said that they have successfully been tested on animals. Definitely, first it would be on animals and then it would be on the human beings. It in the sense, the testing. First the testing will be done on the animals and then later on to the human beings. So the PGI Medical Sciences have said that it has been successfully tested on animals for safety and response. And he also made it very clear that it will take 6 months. And that is what even the scientist from the WHO, the lead scientist at WHO Indian, that is Swaminathan, has also said that it will take minimum 6 to 9 months it will take for the clinical trials, for the phase 1 and phase 2 to go ahead with the final assessment for the safety of the antibodies produced would be made by the safety board. So definitely what is important is the 6 months to 9 months is what the time is required for the vaccine, that is the clinical trials on the humans, that is of the Covaxin by Bharat Biotech. So now this is again an additional information I am giving for you, so that you will understand better about the clinical trials. So first you will have the pre-clinical trials in the laboratory, and then on to the animals, and then the first phase you will have it, second phase, third phase, FDA review, and fourth phase. So first phase is what is going on now, that is it will be for the, what do you say, a small group of people or individuals. It will be, what do you say, they will administer or use it the drug will be administered for a group of people or individuals, 20 to 80. And later on in the phase 2, it will be up to 100 to 300 participants or volunteers. And then phase 3, it is thousands, a large number of participants. And then food and drug administration. FDA is what? Then later on, after phase 3 trial, food and drug. FDA is food and drug administration will review the safety and effectiveness of the drug. Once the first phase, second phase and third phase is been completed successfully, again it will be reviewed by the FDA. This is very important, reviewed by FDA, that is the Food and Drug Administration. Once that is the review is done and it is been approved by the drug, then the phase 4 will be larger in thousands, larger number, then it will be the administering of the drug will be taken into consideration. So these are the various phases. This I have taken it for your benefit. This is not part of the newspaper, but for your benefit, that you will understand it better, that how many phases are there in the clinically tested drug for the any vaccine. It is not only in regards to this one, that is the COVID-19, but if you look at in regards to the Ebola virus vaccine, for the Ebola virus vaccine, for HIV, we do not have vaccine as of now. Even now we do not have HIV vaccine. Ebola virus and also Nipah virus and Hendra virus, SARS-CoV-2 virus, SARS virus and also MERS, Middle East Respiratory Syndrome. So for all these you will have the clinical trials, you have different phases. So these phases are very important for you to understand from the prelims point of view and conceptual point of view. And for conceptual point of view, it is important that you need to understand this application or conceptual point of view. I'm extremely sorry. Or application point of view. Application point of view. Fine. And before I get to the topic, next slide. Suresh Raman has joined. Very good morning to Suresh. I'm actually at the verge of completing it, but you will be benefited definitely if you follow what you say, the recorded one. Do follow the recorded one. And many of them have asked me a question to be given for the mains examination, for the mains also. So I have started this. I have taken this question for today. You can note it. Please do note it. I will give you some time. I will read and you please note it. I will dictate it. Please do note it. For the mains point of view. Why I am saying is, for the mains, for general essay. General essay. Why? Because one of the topic in general essay is education or higher education. It could be education. Education. So one of the topic for general essay is education. That is why I am saying for mains general essay it will be important. Please do take this question. In India, Uniform Education System (UES) Uniform Education System having common syllabus and common curriculum. Common syllabus and common curriculum would achieve the code of common culture, removal of disparity and depletion of discriminatory values in human beings, and depletion of discriminatory values in human relations. Full stop. It would enhance virtues and improve the quality of life. It would enhance virtues and improve the quality of life, elevate the thoughts which advances constitutional philosophy, which advances constitutional philosophy of equal society. Discuss. So this is in regards to the mains general essay education. Fine. In India, uniform education system having common syllabus and common curriculum would achieve. That means there is a possibility. That is what to discuss. There is a possibility. That is what I am saying, discuss. Would achieve the code of common culture, removal of disparity,
and depletion of discriminatory values in human relations. First off, it would enhance virtues and improve the quality of life, elevate the thoughts which advances constitutional philosophy of equal society discuss. And now, recapitulate of DNA. Recapitulate in the sense recap. Now we will recap what we have discussed. So we have discussed about the Prime Minister's calls from uniformed multilateralism. So we have discussed this in regards to uniform multilateralism, that is in regards to United Nations Security Council. We have discussed all that. So what Prime Minister is talking about, the reforms in the multilateralism. And then the next one what we have discussed is the personal eminent personalities asking the panel, that is the National Committee, reforms in regards to the penal laws. So to suspend work. So they wanted more, that not 6 months, but more than that. And then the other one is, so this is in regards to again polity. As I said, polity. This second one is in regards to the polity. First one is in regards to the India, how it wanted to go ahead with multilateralism, that is international relations. Fine. And then UN backs Pakistan, UN backlist. UN blacklist Pakistan Taliban leader. Here, United Nations Security Council Resolution 1267. This is important for again IR current affairs. And then the other one is Supreme Court refuses to entertain plea for a uniform and common curriculum for school students. So again, this is again in regards to the mains point of view and also prelims point of view, that is in regards to the education or the reforms in the education system. Reform in education system. We have discussed that. And the fifth one is COVID-19 biotech starts human trial at RPGI Rohtak. So this is in regards to the science and technology, the question for prelims also, which we have discussed. This is again in regards to the clinical trials on humans. So we have discussed at length. So this is what we have recapped. So Prime Minister, reform multilateralism, penal laws, and then UNSC, United Nations Security Council Resolution 1267, global terrorist, and then global terrorist blacklisting as a global terrorist and global terrorist organizations, and then uniform and common curriculum, and then COVID-19 vaccine, that is Covaxin. So this is the recap of what we have actually discussed today in regards to the DNA. So I would thank you all, and then a very good luck to you. Thank you and very good luck. And I would read this, all the studying you are doing will be worth it in the end. All the studying you are doing will be worth it in the end, and good luck. So whatever you are studying will definitely be worth. It will not go waste at all. It will definitely have worth. So do not, be any kind of situation that what you are reading is not really, you are not into the exact mode of UPSC. No, you will be definitely in the mode of UPSC. That is what I am saying. All the studying you are doing will be worth it in the end. So have patience. Definitely you will have the worth of it. And then before you sign off, please do like. I hope this was an informative, knowledgeable session, DNA. And then please do like it, share it and subscribe it. And do visit the akasias.com website. And then the Telegram link of AKSIAS Academy, that is Advanced Knowledge System, is t.me/aks.ias. And my personal Telegram link, you can connect to me also. That is t.me/SandeepBhushanSBT. t.me/Sandeep, S capital, B capital, SBT capital. And then do follow the consistency. And then do stick to the schedule. This is very important. Consistency, schedule is very important. And then making sure that you take care of your physical health and mental health. And then see you again on Monday at 7:30 a.m. See you on Monday again at 7:30 a.m. Malvika Sajivan. Yes, definitely about editorial. Please do visit AKSIS Academy and then take the further information. Definitely AKSIS Academy is planning for it. Is definitely planning for it. Malavika. It is definitely planning for it. And then you please visit AKSIS Academy, or please do download the mobile app of AKSIS Academy also. There you will also have the phone numbers. You can please contact the phone number for the, what do you say, editorial sessions. You can further contact the AKSIS Academy. You will have the phone number there. You can please contact Rahul and Malvika, Madhu, everyone, David, everyone who are all wanting for the editorials. Definitely you are all used to it. So AKSIS Academy will definitely go ahead with editorial sessions. No doubt about it. But please do approach or visit the AKSIS.com or download the mobile app. And then please do call up the AKSIS Academy. You will have the phone number and then you will get the clarity of it. Okay, thank you. And I would say a very big thank you to you all. And before that, Bharat Kalyan has joined. There is no app in App Store. Okay, if not, please do visit the aks.is.com or do call this phone number. You have the phone number also. You have the phone number, Bharat. You can also call the phone. You can also call up the Advanced Knowledge System Academy, IS Academy, on the phone number. You will definitely get it. Anup says, how to remember? And one thing is, Anup, what is important is that you be in the consistency. This is very important. That is why I said consistency. That is, you should not miss it. You should not miss it. Then only you will get that, what you say, you can remember everything. What is important is consistency is important. Read, revise, repeat. Or read, revise, or repeat. Repeat. These are the mantra for you to remember. Anup and everyone, read 3 hours. I have said it, read how to follow the newspaper also. I have given a session. There also you can find it. So read, repeat, and revise. Fine. And then see you again on Monday 7:30 a.m. And I would say a very big thank to everyone. Rahul says the link to get app is also available in details. Okay, fine. Thank you, Rahul, to giving that information to all of our to your friends and to my friends also. Fine. And then see you on Monday. Take care. Happy weekend. But do not enjoy much. Do stick to your schedule.